Hi, I'm Catharine Duffy. Welcome to this video series to take you through the accounting for loss carrybacks and loss carryforwards. This accounting scenario that we're going to go through is going to be a fairly straightforward one, so nothing too complicated, just to give you an idea of how you would handle it. Now, the whole example here is based on today's tax laws, so that today's tax laws say that you can carry back a loss that you incur, a taxable loss. If you're a corporation, you can carry it back for up to 3 years and ask for a refund of any taxes you paid in the last 3 years. That's different from what it is for personal taxes. You know, unfortunately, if you incurred a loss for personal taxes this year, you're not allowed to ask for money back from taxes you paid in the prior years. Wish you could, but you can't. So if corporations, they would look back 3 years ago and say, hey, did I pay any money then? And if I did, ask for some money back. And if that covered off the whole loss, then everything's done. You ask for that money back this year. If there was still more loss to apply, then you would look at 2 years ago and you'd look at 3 years ago, or 1 year ago. So you do that. Now, if you still have tax losses that you did not use up by carrying them back to the prior 3 years, then you hold on to those and make a note in your tax return, and you carry them forward, and you can carry them forward and check every single year for the next 20 years. And as soon as you have a taxable income situation in a year, you can apply the loss against it and reduce how much tax you have to pay in that year. So you can do that until you use up your tax loss carry forward or until the 20 years runs out, whichever happens first. In this example that we're going to use, I've made a very simple assumption that there are no permanent differences, no timing differences, so there's no deferred taxes in this situation at all. So you just make the simple assumption in this particular company that the accounting income for tax before tax equals the taxable income, which is not a very realistic assumption, but what you learn in these examples, you can apply that even if you've got permanent differences or timing differences. So here are the facts that we're going to use to go through this example on loss carrybacks and carryforwards. So we're currently sitting in the year fiscal year 2017 for this company, but just some information you need to understand. So for 2014, 15, and 16, these were the taxable income situations, and this is the current tax that was paid. And as we said at the start of the videos, that we're assuming there's no timing differences, so there was no deferred tax entries that needed to be made in those years. Now we're in 2017 and we have a taxable loss of $80,000. So how do we do the accounting for that? And that's what we're going to work through in the next few stages. So now we're ready to start doing the calculation of the tax entries for 2017. And the first entry that we're going to do is the calculation of the current tax. So this is our rough work to compute what our journal entry should be for current tax expense. So we've got taxable income that was given in the facts of this question of $80,000, and it was actually a taxable loss situation of $80,000. Okay. So we'll take that loss and we'll look back to up to 3 years ago. And so 3 years ago was 2014, and we'll see if there was any taxable income paid. And we know from the facts of this question that there was. So we will carry back our loss to 2014. And in the facts of the question, they stated that we paid tax on taxable income of $5,000. So we're going to ask for a refund of the tax that we paid on that $5,000 income. So $5,000 times the tax rate equals a $1,500 refund that we want to ask for. So the tax rate we're using here is not the 2017 tax rate, it's the tax rate of the year that you paid the tax on. So you can only, you ask for the money back based on the rate you paid it at, not based on the current year's rate. Whether the rate's higher or lower this year, it doesn't matter. Use the rate from 2014. That leaves us with a taxable loss of $75,000. So we still have more loss that we can carry back. So let's check 2015. And if you look back to the facts of 2015, we paid tax on taxable income of $10,000 at a tax rate of 28%. So the refund we're going to ask back this year, in 2017, is a refund of $2,800 based on the carryback to 2015 tax year. But we still have loss remaining. So we still have $65,000 of loss remaining. So we're going to go back to our last year and look and see if we can use up any of this loss by carrying it back to last year. So our carryback to 2016 the last tax year that we had, in 2016, we had taxable income of $15,000, and we paid tax on that taxable income at the rate of 26%. So we're going to ask for a refund of the full $3,900 that we paid in tax last year. But we still have a loss remaining. So remaining loss. So we have a remaining loss of $50,000. But we can't carry back any more years and ask for a refund this year. So what we can do is make note of that $50,000, and we're going to carry that forward for the next 20 years. Or hopefully faster than 20 years, but we can take up to the next 20 years to ask for a reduction of our taxes based on this loss. Just to wrap up the current tax piece though, we've got these three refunds here. They add up to $8,200 in refund. $8,200 of refund. So we'll do a journal entry to request a refund of the taxes here. Debit income tax recoverable and a credit income tax benefit for $8,200. So now it's time to do the deferred tax calculation to set up any deferred tax asset that we might need to record that represents the benefit that we could have from this loss carry forward. So we ended the year in 2017. We have a loss carry forward of $50,000. And as the accountant, you have to ask yourself, do we think we can actually use up this loss carry forward in the next 20 years of time? And you know, in the real world, probably the answer is an obvious yes, because how many companies are going to last for 20 more years if they're incurring loss carry losses every year? So we've got to assume we're going to be in a taxable situation sometime in the next 20 years. However, just to illustrate the differences in the accounting, I'm going to make the assumption that we estimate that we are only going to be able to use 80% in the next 20 years. That we're only going to have enough taxable income to use up 80% of that loss carry forward. So 20% cannot be used ever. So that affects our accounting in 2017, because what we're going to say to ourselves is, okay, we've got this loss carry forward of $50,000, but we only think we can use 80% of it. 80% of $50,000 is a $40,000 loss. And it's going to be based on that $40,000 loss that we're going to establish our deferred tax asset, or the benefit that we expect we're going to get in future years when we're able to reduce our taxes by this loss carry forward. So we'll look at future. You know, we're doing the deferred tax calculation, so it's not the current tax rate that we want, it's the future tax rate that we want. So if the future tax rate is different, we should use it. And in the facts that were given in this question at the beginning, we said that starting in 2018, the tax rate is 21%. So the $40,000 loss times the 21% rate will be, says that we need to set up a deferred tax asset of $8,400. So we need a deferred tax asset in 2017 to record this loss carry forward. So debit deferred tax asset, $8,400, credit deferred tax benefit, the income statement account, $8,400. So that is the value that we're saying the loss carry forward is to us now. The 20% that we don't think we'll ever use, we're not going to set up any deferred tax asset for that. If we change our mind next year or the year after or any time in the next 20 years, that's okay. We'll just do our calculation of what we think the deferred tax asset is, and we'll adjust the value to what we think it is. But for now, we'll just assume that we can only use 80% of this. Okay, we'll take a break here, and when you're ready, you can continue in the next video.